Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to extract data from a complex invoice PDF file. And if you look into this PDF file that I have, it's a little bit complex. Let me explain why. I have line items. So the first problem is that this line items is expanded into multiple pages. Okay, it's in all 10 different pages. So let me show you this one. So this is the first page. This is the second page. This is the third page, this is the fourth page, and so on. And if I go into the last page, that's the 10th page, I have line items in this particular page as well. So that's the first complex part, okay? That it's expanded into 10 different pages. Now, the next complex part is that it doesn't have any grid line, okay? If you look into this row and columns, it doesn't have any grid line, okay? That's the another challenging part when we want to extract data from a PDF file as a table. Then that's another challenging part. So that's the second part. And then the third part is that if you look into this, that this style and color, it doesn't repeat for all the sizes. So it's like, you know, style, color, and this description, it's only appear once for the first size, and then it's like blank. So we need to fill it down for all the sizes, okay? So that's another little bit problematic part. And I have noticed another thing that if you look into this section, this two line is basically for one size, right? This one as well. So that's another complex part, okay? So what we need to do, we need to extract the data from this particular PDF invoice. And also we need to extract the metadata from this invoice. So metadata means like, you know, I need to extract the invoice number, invoice date, invoice due date, that one, and the final total amount. So that is this balance due, okay? Or you can just use this one, total amount, okay? Now, let's see the expected output first and then I'll show you, okay? So this is our expected output. So the SQ, that is basically the style, color, and size, concatenation. Then we have description, then we have unit of measurement, quantity, unit price, and total line price for that particular line item. So that's our expected output and it has 281 rows, 6 column. And then we have metadata, that is the invoice number, invoice date, invoice due date and total amount. So that's the metadata part. So let me explain how to extract this information using PDF Plumber. In previous videos, I have used PyMoPDF. You can use that library as well. But for this one, I wanted to experiment with PDF Plumber. It was a little bit interesting to experiment that. So let's see. So first thing that you should notice is that the first page has lots of information at the top, right? You can see this part, and from the next page to the last page we have only this much of information, right? So when we want to extract table from a PDF file, we have a couple of options, okay? One is that lines, another one is lines strict. So what does line means? That if you have a grid line, okay, then PDF library will be able to identify those lines as a grid line, and then it will be able to extract the information. But if you look into this particular PDF file, then you'll see that I don't have any grid lines, right? Here, I don't have any grid lines for rows or columns, only at the header rows. So that's the first problem. So that's why we need to use text property instead of lines or lines strict, okay? So that's this horizontal strategy is text. You can use vertical strategy text as well, but that's okay. So that's the text. But for the vertical part, what I wanted to do, I wanted to specify the what's the reason for each of the column, okay? So what I mean to say is that I want to extract what's the starting point for this first column and what's the ending point for the first column or the second column starting point. So I'm explaining that my first column started left side of the S of this style keyword and ends at starting point of C for the color part, okay? So that's the coordinate, the vertical coordinate, X points, okay? And I want specifically specify for all of these particular columns. So that's why we have these vertical lines and it says 14.4, 62.4 and so on. Now, this is a little bit confusing for you that, okay, how do I get this particular number, right? It's not something that I just made up on my mind and it will work, right? So we need to find this particular vertical lines. So let me show you how can you extract this particular information first. So in PDF Plumber or PyMoPDF, there is a specific method that is for searching that particular text, okay? And that will return you some information. So let me show you. that let's say I'm just working at page zero, so pdf.pages, and then I have page.charts, and I can just search for style, okay, and just print this particular information to see what we get. So let me run this, and you can see it says style, and then x coordinate, you can say x0, it says 14.4. So x coordinate means, like, you know, it's a starting point. X0 means starting point for the x coordinate. There is y0 as well. So y0 means top point of this S character. And x1, that means the ending point of this style keyword. And y1 means the write down point of this E character. Okay, so it's like, you know, box. What do we need? We just need the x coordinate. So starting x coordinate for style, starting x coordinate for color, and so on. So that's how I get this, that this is 14.4, okay? Now let me show you for this CLR, that's the color. CLR, if I run this again, it says that 62.4, right? X0, 62.4. And now you'll see that this is the 14.4, now 62.4, now 86.4. So if you try for the third one, then you'll see 86.4 and so on. And this is the 585.6, so let me just show you that one. That is this price, okay, extended price. So I'm just going to copy this extended and let's run this. So you can see it says 547.19. So that's why I use 547.2 for the starting part, and then ending part is 585.6. So if you look into this ending part, 585.6, okay. I think for this one, we can just use the phase width. That will be better. So that's how we can specify the ending point as well. Or you can just add some more, like 58.6, you can just make it to 586. It doesn't matter. So that's how we get this vertical line. So what this vertical lines will do, it will just split that page by those particular coordinates, and then it will try to find those columns, okay? And for the horizontal strategy, I'm using text. And for the vertical one, I'm just using the explicit vertical lines coordinate. Now, what is this text Y tolerance and snap Y tolerance? So what does this snap Y tolerance means is that, let me just show you, if I just run this without snap tolerance, stop this printing, pd.concat. Okay, so you can see there are some blank rows like this one. You can see this blank rows, right? Then we have another blank rows. So let me just show you that head 10. So you can see we have blank rows, we have blank rows, we have blank rows, and so on. So what does this snap tolerance does is that if we have this much of space in between two lines, then it will combine those into one line, okay? That's the snap Y tolerance. So this snap Y tolerance default value is, you know, 3. It's experimental, okay? You need to try and experiment that, okay, what's the best for this particular PDF file, okay? So I just use 7. Now, if I run this now, then still you can see I have some blank rows, okay, like this one. So you need to experiment a little bit more, like let's say 8. And if I use 8, then there is no blank rows in between those two rows. So you can see with the 7, I get one blank rows like this, each rows. And with 8, I don't get any blank rows. So that's how I get this snap Y tolerance. And that's how we need to experiment, okay? So this is the snap tolerance. So this is all the property, okay? Horizontal strategy text. Snap Y tolerance is 8. And text Y tolerance is 6. So if you want to join text, so that's just going to be the 6. So it's just looping through each page, okay? I'm just opening the PDF file with pdmplumber.open. Then I'm getting this for searching. Then I'm just looping through each page index. And then I'm getting the page. And now it says page index equals to 0. Then top is 234. And for this one, top is 145. So what does this mean is that, as I said, for the first page, you can see we have a little bit more information at the top. So the style start at 234. But for the next page and one word, this style start at 145. So this is also experimental, okay? So you need to just search for the style keyword for the page, and then you'll see that what is the Y0 coordinate position, okay, for this style. Now we get this top position. So for the first page only, that is the 234. For the second to one word, it's 145, okay? Now we need to crop this particular page into a box, okay? So that's why I use B box is starting at x0 is 0, y0 is just the top position, and x1 is just space width, and y1 is space height, okay, because it's expand till the end of the space, okay, except this space 2 of 10. You can try to extract this information and then you can also limit this a little bit, but that's okay. And now I get this one, I just crop this particular space and then I'm just using extract table in that particular cropped section, okay. And now it will give me a list of lists in PDF plumber. So I need to convert this into a data frame. So I have this simple function at the top, like this one. So pd.dataframe list. So the rows going to be like, you know, one to one more, that is the second line items to n line items, and column is just the first line items on that particular list of lists. So that's the 2df function. And then I'm just using this bckord is na. If it's is na, then filter this by our df. So that is important for the last page actually. So if you look into this last page, then it's considered this information a little bit, this information as well as a part of the table. So you can add validation that, okay, it's like, no, we need to find this shipping consolidation summary, and then we can limit that part. But I don't want you to do that. So I just filter out that based on this bckord, because for this one, it was extracting some text from this section. So that's a good point for me. So I just filter that out. For each phase, I get the data frame. Now I'm just appending that into this, okay? Now I'm just appending that. Now we need to do some cleanup, okay? So like, you know, I need to find this, okay, it's blank. SIP is not blank. So SIP is just basically the shipping quantity, okay, quantity SIP. So that should not be blank, right? That's how I just do some filtering. If you look into this. So I get this, then I just filter out that blank rows, okay? And then I just replace now empty string with NA so that I can do the filling up, okay? Like, you know, NA, NA, someone. And then fill down, and then renames columns, okay? So I get quantity, unit price, line price, okay? Quantity, BKORD, okay? And show what? Now, I just need to recalculate some stuff. So let me just show you. So I need to convert this quantity to a numeric value. Okay. That's the type changes. Okay. Now unit price, I need to convert this unit price to a numeric as well. And line price, that should be a numeric as well. And SKU, that is just a combination of style, color and size. And unit of measurement is just WHS. Okay. So if I just run this, then I'll get like this. So unit price is converted to a proper number, line price, and as well as this quantity is converted to a proper numeric values. And then I'm just, you know, removing all the quantity that is not a number or NA. So it'll just remove that. It's some cleanup process, okay? Now I'm just dropping all the columns which has all the blank values, okay? So like there are some columns which is only blank. So I don't need to keep that particular column. And then I just need to reorganize this stuff. And this is our expected output for the line items. Now, let me show you that for the metadata part. So this is also interesting part, okay? So for the metadata part, what we need to do? We need to find the position of this one, starting position to till this position. I need to find what's the position for this one as well. So I can just slice it down to like just select this part and just give me the data, okay? I can slice it down for this part and just give me the date. I can slice it down for this part and give me that invoice number, okay? And that's what I am doing. Like now, I'm just getting the first phase. I'm just extracting the B box. So this B box is nothing but an Excel. And then invoice date. So just clip this and replace with like, you know, replace this colon with empty string. Split that by a new line and then get the first part and strip that. In the same way, I'm getting invoice due date, invoice number and total amount, okay? Same thing. And then I'm just converting into a dictionary and then adding as a data frame. And that's it. So that's how you can extract the information from a PDF files. There are multiple properties when you use extract table in PDF plumber as well as in PyMoPDF. There is like, you know, find tables and there are multiple properties that you can specify. So I think you should try out and you should understand that which property is useful for which particular condition. And then you should try out and you will get the information easily, okay? So that's it for this video. If you find this video helpful, please subscribe to this particular channel and hit the bell icon for future content. Have a good day.